So down the line, if you guys start building this stuff up that I've been using the stepping I got too much going on between my ears right now, and I'm coffee drunk to say the very least, and sleep deprived, and I think I have headphones in. Either way, I can show you guys, it's essentially the opposite of pi, crudely speaking, and it facilitates death in many ways. This is what I'm trying to spit out, is I can show you guys the grassroots approach to understand why 187 is 187, how it relates to quite literally the left-hand path and death and all that other shit, and how that sings to the flip side of it, because each maintain the other. It's quite beautiful. People could work this out. I've never found this anywhere else, and you probably won't either, because people aren't, you know, cooking with fire. In the event that these things offend you, or you find them concerning, you know, my sharp tongue, if you just pay attention, people don't have a clue what's going on. And you don't find genuine grassroots answers to reality, despite the fact that there are nothing but answers to reality. And it's fucking beautiful. And the more I do this, the more jaded and... you guys have heard me. It's also, I mean, I have to say it too, because there's a flip side. It's fucking hilarious. It's fucking hilarious. Especially if you go out in public and you listen to people talk about just pointless fucking shit. Superficial shit. When they start waxing poetic about how they think the, you know, everything works. It's garbage. It's our master's adult fairy tales. You rarely hear people out in public, or online for that matter, discuss something that truly has a foundation to stand on, that is interconnected with everything else. I mean, what you hear in public is about as good as this trash pile on this bus stop. I mean, it's shit. It's shit. I don't want you to take my word for it. I need people to look into it so that they understand it, but most people don't want to put in the time. Most people aren't willing to stay the course. You know, they don't have grit. This is why I say people aren't worth their salt, but they could be. Either way, you get the point. And this is one of the many things I can teach you. What I'm doing right now is I'm taking all the bits and pieces and I'm building up this system that describes how shit works. It's intricate in ways that I find daunting, but other times it just flows. It's just streamlined, because once you start doing it, just like anything, you become accustomed to it. Either way, you guys probably know what I'm getting at with that. Sometimes I'll rattle stuff like that off in a video because it helps me process it. And I'll start seeing it different ways because I'm expressing it, so to speak, and it's interacting with this junk. It's weird how it reflects back and how it will reshape how you see things, how you do things, and what you perceive and grasp. Maybe I'll leave it at that. If you hung out, thanks for hanging out with me while I wait for a bus, like the classy fellow I am. Oh, and don't forget, most people think today is the end of the year. There's a lot of, you know, Happy New Year. That's not going to happen until March 21st, approximately. You know, Pisces leading into Aries. You know, the feet touching to the head. And if you guys don't know what that relates to, it relates to Israel or Jacob, the heel catcher. You got to think in terms of yourself, from the ground to the crown. That's how everything works. People talk about toroidal fields, but they don't understand when the new year is. Instead, they're talking about December, you know, Sagittarius bleeding into Capricorn. Just look up the body parts. It doesn't make any fucking sense. That's the shortcut to thinking, and it would come up a lot, but again, most people don't have an oar in the water, but what the fuck do I know? So here's a little postscript. I'm waiting on another bus. So what I was going to rattle off is this process that I'm referring to is subject to the multiples of seven. And I've left some of these answers online years ago, but most people aren't taking notes and or giving, you know, two shits. If they had been, then they would already have some of these answers already built up. So when they hear me rattle stuff like this off, they'd have something to work with. This is how our masters conduct their lesser magic, if you aren't paying attention at all. When you see lesser magic in a movie, every last bit of, you know, the quote-unquote answers or the big picture isn't painted for you in one fucking sitting. And most people don't realize that. Same reason you have people out there that will complain and want answers in 1 minute now because our masters are doing away with attention spans. Yeah. So when you think about the number 7 being holy, it's also anomalous, but it's bound between these two things. The other thing you'd probably want to consider is, or reconsider for that matter, is why were we told to rest on the seventh day? How does that factor into the sixth day? Because this is also very important. This touches on what I've rattled off numerous times. It's something the ancients taught us about sleep being 1/60th of death. In other words, you know, 1.67. Sixes and sevens. There's an expression that I overuse related to sixes and sevens. And people still don't understand that either. I know, I sound like a prick, but it's a fact. And if people just thought for themselves, they would. To be at sixes and sevens denotes confusion. And how many times have I told you that our masters are polarizing people, people don't have a foundation to work with, etc., right? They don't know the difference between the mother and the father. They don't understand that we're based on that. And I'm talking about the specifics, which you could reason out. Talked about the crude matter, and I've talked about the light within. I often rattle off that I'm carrying around, or I have a bipedal sack of meat that carries my light. I'm talking about the binary or dualistic aspect of reality, related to specifically the sixes and the sevens. And I think in some of the recent videos I've rattled off, again, you should really think about 13 and 42 in that case, you know, that are produced through the sixes and the sevens. It's important. But as always, what the fuck do I know? If you hung out with me, thanks for spending the time and energy, blah, blah, blah. Yeah. Enjoy your night, internets. So you'll see some of this online sometimes, but these kids that are rattling this off are still celebrating the new year at the end of December. So break down the etymology of the 12 months, respectively. And you just think of December to start with. I mean, that's 10, deca. Simple as that. That's the 10th, not the 12th, so to speak. So it's clearly not the end of the year. What was the other thing I was going to rattle off? Oh, if you just think in terms of March, I mean, March is the end of that cycle, is it not? It's the 12th sign, so to speak. I really want you to think about that agenda we lived through in 2020 and any other agenda that might come to mind. And the fact that people buy into it, they fall in the line, they do what our masters want. So if people were thinking for themselves and willing to stand up and do what's what, you know, what's right, first and foremost, what fucking reflects reality. And by extension, harmoniously benefits us because it reflects reality. It promotes abundance, not the opposite, in other words. Why aren't people doing the right thing and willing to say, hey, that's not the new year? I'm not celebrating that because it's not the new year. It's a narrative, an adult fairy tale that our masters sold people. They bought into. It's been normalized. And now people just do it. Without thinking. Again, you still have people who talk about the toroidal field, but
but they celebrate the new year at the end of December because everybody else is doing it, or at least the moral majority, the vast majority of the John Q. public, who are unwilling to do the right thing. They're not willing to draw a line in the sand. This is also why there will be no revolution. Sure as shit won't be televised, and it's not going to happen.